Hey guys, Harsh here, back in the video. So today I'm going to do a comparison video on the i12 TWS earphones and the i9 TWS earphones. And both of them are pretty good earphones in terms of pricing, because this cost almost $10 and this almost cost me around $8 or $9. So that's pretty cheap, I think. And if you want to check the reviewer's guide and how to charge and pair them, I have made a separate video on both of them. So all the links are in the description, you can check them out. And in those videos, I have shown you how you can connect and pair with these earphones and connect and pair these earphones. So I have made a separate video on i9 version and the i12 version. So let's get started. Okay, so by taking a closer look at the earphones, they do not look very different from each other, except for the little color discoloration from this version. This is a bit warmer and this is a bit older color whiteness to it, but that's, I think, not a very huge difference to make. So at the bottom, they have the same charging port with the metal ring around it, so that is going to provide an extra strength for them. And at the back, they have the same layout with the metal hinge holding down the lid and the button for the charging option. And from the side, they look absolutely the same, and as well as from the front. So let's take them out of the case and see what they have in common. So as you can see that the slit on the i9 version is slightly bigger than the i12 version. And I don't know what that is for, anything about it. Now the real difference begin when you take them out of the case. So this is the i12 version, and once I take them out of the case, you can see that there is a huge difference in the earpod styles of the i9 and the i12. So as you can see that this is the i12 and this is the i9. And one of the main differences that you might notice is the absence of a button on the i12 version, because it has a touch sensitive feature. So that's an upgrade from a solid button over here in the i9 version. So the i9 version has a button over here which you can push it to control the different aspects of the i9 TWS. So you can press it to pair and disconnect or turn off the earphones. And it is same with the i12 version, it's just that it has a touch sensitive area right beneath the slit. So this area which my finger is now resting at is the touch sensitive area of the i12. The build quality is almost the same. They have the charging ports at the bottom and their ear style is almost similar to the original Apple AirPods. And there is a chance of accidental clickiness, as I did just right now. So I have accidentally pressed the touch sensitive area and now it is right now going to pairing mode. So that's the thing you gotta watch out for, unlike the i9 version where you have to press the button firmly to get the AirPod started. So that's a downside about the i12 and upside about the i9. In terms of speaker quality, they are both almost identical. Now I would say that the i12 are a bit louder in comparison to the i9 version, but I think the speaker quality on both of them is just similar. So if you are worrying about the sound quality, they are both exactly the same sounding. So that's, I think, a pretty strange thing, because from i9 you go to i12 and still you have a same speaker quality except the touch sensitivity option. Now the earphones are also a bit different in terms of height. So the i9 version, which is over here, has a bit shorter height than the i12 version. So if I place them side by side, you can see that the i9 falls a bit shorter to the i12 version. Now the one thing good about the i12 is that you can just directly place them in the case and they will right away go into the charging mode, and the blue LED on the case will automatically turn on, unlike the i9 version where you have to put them in the case first and then turn on the back button so that the case is turned on and the earphones are in charging mode. So that's a thing to watch out for. And turning on off the case is similar, just you have to press the button again to turn both of them off. Now the cases all are also a bit different in size, So the i9 version, which is over here, is a bit shorter than the i12 version. So if you place them side by side, you can see that there is a slight difference of height in them. But it's not very that much, so you will be fine. If you are worried about the size, then I would say go for the i9 version, because the sound quality of this earphone and this earphone is basically the same, just a bit louder on the i12 version. Alright guys, thanks for watching the video. Hope you like it. Please like, subscribe and share, and stay tuned for more videos like this.